Dave Brown and Corey Macklin here at ringside, ready to go with another day of USWA Championship Wrestling.
Another big one indeed, Dave. Harris Brothers, Run and Dunn Harris, and Mike Samples, they're in here in the opening bout today. Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, he's going to be here today as well. Not only that, Jeff Jarrett is here today. And to the expiration of time, the King, Jerry Lawler, and the Missouri Tiger, Jeff Gaylord. Well, of a day today.
Should be a big one. There's more, too. Lots more. Stay with us. We'll get it underway right after these messages. Doug Gilbert is out here. And, Doug, you have something you need to say to the fans?
Yeah, Dave, first of all, I want to tell you, I'm sorry about a few things I said last week. I was running my mouth when I should have been listening. You know, Eddie sat out here and he said a lot of things and made me think about a lot of things, Dave. When I was young, I run around with a wild group of people, and he'd tell me, he said, Doug, if you don't watch what you're doing, you're going to get in trouble. Dave, I thought a lot about that. He tells me last week, he says, you need to watch what you're doing and everything. So I look back, I look who I'm running around with. Running around with the Harris brothers, which, you know, everybody says they're bad company. You run around with Bert, Prentice, and Mike Samples. Everybody says they're bad company. You run around with Lex Luger and Brian Christopher. And Brian Christopher, all he does, he carries me with him because he's a punk. And when he gets in a fight, Dave, I'm the one that has to fight the fight. But later on in the week, I did fight my brother, right, Dave? I wrestled him, but I did draw my fist back. And I hit him, Dave.
Yeah, you did.
And I should never have done that. But on the latter part of the week, I talked to my mother, and she said, son, I didn't bring you and Eddie up to be fighting each other. And I said, no, Mom, I'm sorry. I'm real sorry about that. And I said, I told him I didn't even want to wrestle him again, but it's done booked, and I've got to wrestle. But I told my mother, Dave, I said, I will never draw my fist back at my brother ever again. I would never do that. And see, my brother right now, Dave, a lot of people don't know, he's still not even talking to me. But that's why I asked you for a minute out here this morning, because I do want to tell him, Dave, he will always be my brother, and I do love him.
Well, there's a word from Doug Gilbert. After his attitude last week, it's refreshing to hear the things that he had to say, not only to the fans, but also to his brother. So if Eddie's listening, I hope he heard the apology there from Doug. Ron and Don Harris headed to the ring right now. Mike Samples, their manager, is with them. And yes, they do have the World Tag Team belts with them. They won the belts a few days ago, much to the pleasure of Mr. Samples. Samples had his hair on the line in that match and kind of gave... Kind of gave me the impression that he might not show up again if he lost his hair.
Yeah, I thought the same thing. There's the Harris brothers as they get warmed up for their opponent.
You have here, Dave Brown.
Well, I noticed you did show up today, and you do still have your hair. And what's that?
I have the championship belts, the USWA tag team belts right here, like I promised. And I've never broken a promise, and I've never told a lie. And I'm telling you now. You didn't want to believe me. My hair is still intact and in place. These two men, the most deadliest force in professional wrestling, are the champions, and they will never be beaten. But I have a surprise. Next week, right here on this very TV station, live in living color, you're going to get to see Richard Lee bald as a baby's bottom. And that's another promise that I won't break.
Well, we'll see about that. He never told a lie, he said. I don't know about that. Yeah.
But we will be the undefeated champions forever.
Well, I don't know about that either, because you got some rather stiff competition coming up for those world titles in the Moondogs. In there right now. Boy, I tell you what. Oh, my goodness. Right into the ring post goes one of these guys.
By the way, this is Terry and Perry Lawler. This is Jerry Lawler's favorite nephews getting a little wrestling lesson.
It is not Lawler's nephews. This is Steve and Glenn Richards is their name. And they are not having a good day so far, let me tell you.
Nope, not indeed, as the big Bruise brothers go after him. And down on the floor, another one of the Richard brothers. Ron and Don Harris, the USWA World Tag Team Champions, and Mike Samples, glad about it. it as they continue to dominate Steve and Glenn Richards. Only one of the Richard brothers in there now. Oh, boy. Big suplex over, and the Harris brother comes off with a big leg.
These guys wrestle a lot just like the Moondogs, don't they? Down on their back, screaming for help. That's Mike Sample saying that, and then fans, you know the Moondogs don't wrestle anything like this, as a matter of fact.
I know.
Boy, Moondogs don't spend a lot of time on their back either. They spend a lot of time coming right at you, face first, with who knows what from the hardware department.
Big Harris, brother, with a big boot right in the back of...
I don't think you'll be seeing any more hardware coming to the ring, because we have effectively beat the Moondogs into submission.
I don't know about that, Mike Sample. Big power slam from the big Bruise brother. Comes off the ropes again and jumps down on one of the Richard brothers, Steve and Glenn Richards, in the ring.
Yeah, did you hear what Sample said? He said, be sure you hurt him. What a nice guy. Mike Samples and the Bruise brothers, Ron and Don Harris, huh?
Yeah.
They currently have the belts, but the Moondogs are going to be breathing down their neck at every turn, believe you.
Yeah, indeed. Big double boot, boy.
Dave Brown, before you go on and make a fool of yourself, I begged the Moondogs for a match this morning, but you see they're not here.
You begged the Moondogs.
Well, I see the Harris brothers have just gotten the cover and have won the match.
Yeah.
One of them collecting the championship belt.
Oh, boy.
And smashes one of the Richards with it.
See, these belts sort of have a dual purpose, Dave.
Yeah.
It takes them
a dual purpose. Word from Mike Samples again. And now they double team with the other one out here.
Yeah.
These two young guys down here on the floor.
First look at Steve and Glenn Richards, and boy, it's a tough day for them already.
Watch yourself here.
Yeah.
Here's Eddie Marlin. Eddie Marlin's just threatened them with a fine, and that got Mike Samples' attention in a hurry. They're going to be leaving. We'll be back with more from the USWA after. Christopher and Bert Prentice are headed this way. And Brian, I'm surprised, but it sounds like you got a fan or two here today.
That don't shock me, Dave. That doesn't shock me in the least bit. But something I want to talk about. Hey, shut up for a minute. There's something I want to talk about today. Now, last week, I came out here and I introduced the biggest superstar in the world today. I introduced the best wrestler in the world today. And you people gave him zero respect. And that embarrasses me. Because I brought him out here. I made the phone call and got him here, and these hillbillies showed him no respect. So today, now listen to me. Today, when I bring him out here, okay, now what I want is, I want this section over here. I want this section. I want you to get down on your knees, and I want you to start doing like this.
Don't hold your breath.
I want this section to do that, and I want this section over here. I want you to all stand up and start giving him a standing ovation, okay? Then we're gonna see if you imbeciles can follow directions. And when I give you the cue, you get ready. You get down on your knees, and you all stand up. Now, Dave Brown, I got a question. Do you know what the word narcissist means?
I got an idea, but I'm sure you're going to tell it.
Okay, Dave. I know these imbeciles over here do not know what the word narcissist means because you have to go to school in order to learn that. The word narcissist is somebody that is so perfect. It is somebody that does not have a flaw on their entire body. It is somebody that whenever anybody looks at them, they just fall in love with them. And they're so perfect that they fall in love with themselves. That is what a narcissist is. And right now, here's your cue. Get down on your knees, stand up. Right now, I want to introduce the most perfect wrestler in the world today, the greatest man in the world today, the narcissist himself, Lex Luger. Stand up.
I don't see anybody standing. Here is Lex Luger. The narcissist.
There he is, Dave. The man that I've brought in here. The most perfect man I know. Oh, you're so great, Lex. And last week I brought him out here and he scouted the talent around here, and he was gonna see who he would wrestle to prove that he is the greatest man living today. But what we decided to do was we're gonna kill two birds with one stone this week. There's two big studs running around here by the name of Jeff Jarrett and Jerry Lawler. But they just think that they're studs, because this week, me and Lex have decided to get in the ring together and take care of the sissy boy and the so-called king. It's going to be 2-on-2, and we're going to show you why we're the best and why he is the narcissist.
Now, I hear what you're saying. Now, was this his idea? Was this your idea, because you need help in there against Jeff?
This was both of our idea. It's not because I'm mad at Jarrett. It's not because I'm mad at Lawler. They have been running their mouth, but we have decided to kill two birds with one stone. And that Jeff Jarrett really, really makes me mad, because he is the one that cost me the World Unified title. I guess you ain't got the tape of where Jeff Jarrett came down there and screwed me out of the belt. I had the belt won. I would have been the world champion.
Well, as a matter of fact, we do have that videotape, and I want to talk to Lex.
You got it.
But you want to watch the videotape? Let's watch the videotape right here.
Show that.
And breaks with Christopher. Lawler whips him in. Christopher comes off. Well, a big right hand, a big uppercut from Christopher. Nails the king and sends him down. Backs Lawler up against the ropes. He's got Lawler's hair back there while he's holding on to him. Doesn't give him a break either. Big knee lift from Christopher. Whips the king in. Lawler hangs on and does the strut on Christopher. Lawler backs him up. Whips him in. Christopher comes off and stomps down on the king. Big boot right in the neck of Lawler. Christopher does. And boy, he's celebrating. Christopher whips the king into the ropes. Lawler comes off. Oh, stomping at Christopher and misses.
It has got to be obvious. You can't hang with me. I am the superior athlete. You're washed up. Like I said, out with you, in with me.
Lawler whips Christopher into the ropes. Christopher comes off. Jumps down on Lawler. And starts batting him as if he's riding a horse in there, this Christopher does. And Lawler tells every Paul Abrams, get out of here, let me at him. Referee Paul Neighbors and shoves Paul going to the turnbuckles over there. Goes out to Lawler. Kicks him right in the midsection and mallet away on the King. Series of rights from Christopher. Another right hand from Brian Christopher. Mallet away on Jared Lawler. Look at Lawler. Buys Christopher up. Standing in there, and the King tells Christopher, yeah, come on, but hold on just a minute there. Just 1 second, Lawler says. Kicks Christopher in the midsection, nails it, what a right. Another right hand from the King. Lawler comes off the rope, swings, and Christopher sends him down. Big right hand from the King. Comes off the ropes again, and Prentice trips the King up. Brian Christopher dropped one of the elbow. Ball drop the King, it looks like. Here comes Jeff Jarrett. Jeff's got that good talk.
You see what I'm talking about? Jeff Jarrett had to come down there, and he tossed me the world belt.
He didn't touch you. I want to talk. I've heard enough. I want to talk to Lex.
No, I want to talk to Lex. Lex, promise me one thing. This week, when we got Jeff Jarrett and Jerry Lawler, and after you beat that Jeff Jarrett to a bloody pulp, and you pull all that peroxide hair out of his head, and you almost got all the life squeezed out of his body, just promise me that you'll tag me in there and let me have just 2 minutes of him. Promise me.
You know, Brian, I think I can sum all this up for everybody right here and everybody out there. The odds have been evened up and then some. You have nothing to worry about anymore. Because you see, what I just saw on tape there was 2-on-1 with a guitar.
Yeah.
The odds have been totally, abundantly evened up because you see, when I came in here, I said there was a couple studs, like you said, Jeff Jarrett and Jerry, the so-called King Lawler. Well, I love establishing my dominance and superiority over so-called studs. That's what I do best. And now, what they are is a couple big fish in a very small pond. But now you're going to look at what is the biggest fish in the biggest pond of professional wrestling, the superstar of the 90s, the man of the 90s, the narcissist, Lex Luger. Now, what we're gonna do, Brian, is we're gonna humiliate and dominate them like they have never been dominated before. And that is what's gonna happen when we step in the ring with those two.
I cannot wait. Jarrett and Lawler, you see this man? Nobody can beat this man, and you can't beat me either. We're going to take care of you this week.
And now, Brian, let me tell you something. If anybody has an eye for talent in the sport of professional wrestling, it's the narcissist Lex Luger. Now, don't be so humble. It was your idea to wrestle both at once to establish my superiority all at the same time. It was your idea. And let me tell you something. This man has the intelligence. He has the wrestling skills. He's going to go somewhere. He won't be in a small pond for very long. This man here is going to be big things. We're going to start off with Jarrett and Lawler right here, right now.
Well, that's the word from Lex Luger. I thought it was probably his idea. We'll see you in the ring. We'll be back here with more action in a moment. Stars, 10 big matches all coming up Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum. Get ready for this one,
yeah.
The opener of the night. You got the Night Stalker going against Scott Campione.
Campione is some kind of wrestler.
Yeah,
dude.
I think many of the fans have seen him. We've had him here on TV a couple of times, and he has been wrestling in the USWA, and he will be in the opening match against the Night Stalker to get the night of 29 stars underway. Following that, you got Leslie Bellinger, who's going to be going against Regina Hale. That one should be interesting to see, too, as Leslie Ballinger, I think, again, folks know from her association with Bert Prentice and all of that sort of thing. Master of Terror will be in there. One of them will be going in a single match against Aaron Hatchett.
Had our first look at Hatchett Monday night at Leslie Gate. Looks good. This will be a good single bout between Hatchett and Master Terror.
Excellent. Another single match. You got Ms. Texas.
Yeah,
one of the favorites of everybody around here. She'll be going against Candy Kane in a single match. Following that, you got the first tag team action of the night. That new team of PG-13, the rappers, the hip-hop team, will be going against Danny Davis and Chris Michaels in tag team action. Jeff Gaylord, the Missouri Tiger, will be lining up to go against Dr. Tom. Tom Pritchard.
Tom Pritchard.
In the USWA for the action against Jeff Gaylord. Then the Rock and Roll Phantom. This guy has made his presence known in a very unwelcome way. Bert Prentice will be in his corner, but he's going to have to face Oil Trough Texas' very own Dirty Dutch Mantel.
I tell you, that Rock and Roll Phantom does it. He and Bert Prentice try to sing before the matches. They better get ready for this one, because Dirty Dutch will be looking for him Monday night.
Dutch may have Shoe Baby and may cut the performance short come Monday night at the Coliseum. Return grudge match coming up. Doug Gilbert talked about this one a few minutes ago. He is booked in a match against Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, his brother. It's a return grudge, and he said, he really didn't want to go through with the match, but the match is booked. He will go through with it, but he's promised that he will not raise his fist to his brother Eddie Gilbert in this match. Then, Richard Lee's hair is going to be at stake against the tag title. Ron and Don Harris, the Bruise Brothers, with Mike Samples in the corner. Remember last week, Richard Lee and the Moondogs made Samples put his hair on the line. Well, the Harris brothers are the new champions, and so I know Mike Samples was just itching to get the contract reversed so that Richard Lee's hair is now on the line, as the Moondogs will be challenging for the belts now held by Ron and Don Harris, and they're going to be barbers at ringside ready to go.
Yeah, the barbers from the Perfect Cut Salon over on Raleigh LaGrange, they're going to be on hand Monday night to do the haircut, and they are now the official barbers for the USWA now, a Perfect Cut. Hey, if you get your haircut down there on Raleigh LaGrange, you get free tickets to wrestling on Monday night. Well, they're going to be there Monday night at the Coliseum, and I know Richard Lee won't be looking for them.
No, that's very true. He's hoping that they do not have any work cut out for them Monday night. If the Moondogs win it, then he doesn't have to worry about it. And the Moondogs always, always rugged. But that's not all. Main event of the night. You've already heard about it. Lex Luger, the Narcissist, and Brian Christopher, with Bert Prentice over in the corner, will be going against Jerry Lawler and Jeff Jarrett. And as Lex Luger told us, I knew it had to be Brian Christopher's idea, and sure enough it was, but the match should be a good one. Here's Bert Prentice, what?
You two incompetent fools left out the most exciting news of all Monday night. It is me, it is I, live in concert at the Mid-South Coliseum. We're in rehearsals all day today.
Mr. Clyde is in the ring right now. Referee Kevin Christian checking him out, making sure he doesn't have any foreign objects taped to his boots and all that sort of thing.
Yeah, Clyde didn't want him to check him out there at first. And there's his opponent, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert.
Eddie Gilbert headed toward the ring right now for this single match against Mr. Clyde. Hot Stuff in action coming up right here on the USWA Today. We're glad you're with us. Corey Macklin at ringside here. I'm Dave Brown. And this one has been a good one already. We've had some interesting developments. And this match right here, a heavy favorite coming into the match would have to be Hot Stuff, Eddie Gilbert. We're underway.
Yes, sir. Oh, look at Clyde. Goes in after Eddie Gilbert. First mistake and biggest one of all for Mr. Clyde. And that's mistake number two. Eddie Gilbert clobbers him, and Clyde rolls out of there. Mr. Clyde out on the concrete floor there, and Clyde stunned of the happenings. Boy, but that's mistake number one in going against Eddie Gilbert. He's got his eyes open and looking all the time, Dave.
Clyde finally gets back through the rope. He avoids the count out, just barely.
Clyde tangles out with Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. Backs Gilbert. Oh, nails Eddie. Oh!
Yeah, another mistake.
Mistake number three for Clyde as Eddie Gilbert comes back and busts him with a big right hand, huh? A little insult to injury there for Mr. Clyde.
Boy, you don't, there are a couple of folks, you don't double up your fist and hit them. Lawler would be one. Eddie Gilbert would be another.
Gilbert tangles up with Mr. Clyde. Clyde sets him, backs him up, whips him in. Eddie Gilbert hangs on.
Yeah, a little bit of the Fargo strut, which he has modified to the hot stuff strut.
Gilbert, good leg takedown there. Drag Clyde down to the mat. Hold it on to that left leg of Mr. Clyde. Clyde reaching for the hair over there. Didn't quite get it, though. It's Eddie Gilbert. Oh!
You know what he was just saying there without uttering a word? He was just saying, you remember when you hit me with your fist there a couple of minutes ago? Mr. Clyde having a mighty tough day. I think the tide turned on this one about the time the ink dried on the contract that said he had to step in there against Eddie Gilbert.
Clyde jumps in there. Sets in a little test of strength for Mr. Clyde as Eddie Gilbert chests his Clyde out. Mr. Clyde hanging in there a little bit. It's Gilbert Brown.
Look out.
Watch out, though.
Watch your fingers.
Ooh! Mistake number four for Clyde. Eddie Gilbert.
Boy, they're piling up.
Gets him down. Yeah, they're piling up quickly. Eddie Gilbert.
So far, it's mistakes, what, four?
Yeah.
Good moves, zip for Mr. Clyde.
Well, you're doing points. Clyde has already lost this one. Eddie Gilbert takes him down. Good arm takedown from Gilbert. Slams down on that left arm of Mr. Clyde.
He raked him across the eyes.
Yeah, picks Eddie up and slams him down hard, too. Clyde comes off the rope, runs over Eddie, comes back to, misses the stop, misses the splash, and catches a right hand from Gilbert. Hots up Eddie Gilbert, nailing away on Mr. Clyde, backs him up and whips him into the rope. Oh, boot from Clyde in there, and he covers Eddie Gilbert.
Eddie outsmarted him, tapped him on the back. He thought it was a referee. The referee was still counting. He was only at a count of two, and Eddie Gilbert goes after it.
Oh,
a bulldog.
Big bulldog, and boy, I think that's the last mistake that broke the camel's back. Oh, that's the straw that did it. Eddie Gilbert.
Look out, Samples headed for the ring with the Harris brothers.
Here comes the Harris brothers and Mike Samples. Eddie Gilbert holding his own in there. Three against one.
They got him hammered down to the mat now. It's three against one. Samples and the Harris brothers all of a sudden hit the ring. I don't know what Samples' idea is, but he really was going after Eddie Gilbert.
Oh, they pick Eddie up, Dave. Big pile drive on Eddie.
Oh, man. He's going to need some help.
Yeah. We need some help for Eddie.
Here comes Doug. Maybe Doug, there's some help for him as he heads for his brother.
Gilbert doing.
Hey, I got friends. I'm the king of rock. I don't apologize to nobody. Yes, I said I loved him, but you gotta beat some sense into some people's heads. You up?
Oh, come on, Doug Gilbert cheering on his brother.
I thought he was coming out here to help his brother. He's out here and claiming that he doesn't apologize for anything.
Hey, Dave. I told you I was the king of rock, and look what's happening. I've got good friends. What's going on?
Yeah, I think he's got some friends now, though, Doug. Here comes the Moondogs and Richard Lee. Well, big trash can and Ford leveled away on the Bruise brothers and Mike Samples. Split the board on the Bruise brothers. And, boy, we've got ourselves a brawl, Moondog style. And Richard Lee come out, jump on the Harris brothers. Oh, Moondog's butt. He's got the big Harris brother over in the crowd over there. Jumping on him, nailing away on him with right hand. We've got a wild brawl here now. Started off,
with all of the Bruise Brothers and Mike Samples all jumping on Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. And the brawl continues. Mike Samples stumping down on Richard Lee.
Eddie Marlin is out here, and maybe we can get some order restored.
Yeah, we need some.
Or the brawl continues. Richard Lee and Mike Samples really going at it up here in the ring. Eddie Gilbert just nailed Samples from behind with that garbage can. The boards are flying, the garbage can too, as the Moondogs hit the ring. Well, as Samples said earlier, no hardware. He's eliminated the hardware. I don't think so.
Not at all.
Might be an indication of things to come for the Harris brothers as the Moondogs.
Well,
look at this. They got Richard Lee over in the corner, though.
Yeah.
Doubling up on it.
Richard. Here comes the big Moondog splat, though. He helps him out. Barber's down on Samples. Boy, we got a wild brawl. Referee Kevin Chris is trying to get them all out of there. Not working, though. The Bruise Brother in the corner. Look out for the splash from the Moondog. Oh, boy. The other Moondog spot has picked up one of the benches over in the crowd. Nailing away on the Bruise Brother. They're out on the floor.
One of the Bruise Brothers just hit Eddie Marlin.
Yeah. Boy, now. Hey.
All right. The Moondogs got it. Getting them out of here. And the Moondogs have cleared the studio. Let's take a break. We'll be right back. Well, we got a couple of guys coming out here right now. I think everybody's waiting to see. Here they come. The King, Jerry Lawler. Man, look at the crowd surrounding him. Here they come, almost over to the interview area right now. Want to talk to him about this situation, Jeff? Tell you what, I know you, of course, you know about the match coming up and that situation with Brian and the guitar and all of that.
Dave, I just want to jump right into it. It seems like I'm so sick and tired of being sick and tired of listening to Brian Christopher come out here week after week after week. And he comes out here and he twists the truth just a little bit. No, he just comes out sometimes and have some bold-faced lies. Now, Brian, film clips do not lie. And that's exactly right. I came down because I watch Jerry's back and he watches my back. That's exactly right. Brian, I never interfered in the match and I never got in the ring and you got your shoulders pinned, 1, 2, 3. Me and Jerry are a tag team and we'll remain a tag team. But Brian Christopher, it seems real, that's right. Brian Christopher, it seems real convenient that I guess the USWA doesn't have the film clip of what happened earlier in the night when I was wrestling the Rock and Roll Phantom. Now, you came down. That's right. Hold you.
We do have
well,
it,
hold
Jeff.
On just a second. Brian Christopher, you came down in the ring with you. It wasn't a wooden guitar. It was a metal guitar. And if Jerry would have been 5 or maybe 10 seconds late, no, I might have been permanently injured or you would have tried to put me in the hospital. And that was your intention, and I'm sure of that. But Jerry came down there and he got the guitar, and that's how I ended up with it. Now, you say you do have the
tape?
Yeah,
we do have it.
You want to take a look at it? Brian Christopher, film clips do not lie. Take a look, pal.
Thank you. Jeff Jarrett and Rock and Roll Phantom. Bert Prentice is trying to get the music going while it's Rock and Roll Phantom. Throws powder right in the eyes of Jeff Jarrett and slams Jeff into the ring railing there at ringside and onto the steps here. Takes that van off that he had around his neck and choking Jeff Jarrett with it. And boy, this Rock and Roll Phantom doesn't give him much of a chance at all. Rock and Roll Phantom sets up Jeff Jarrett. Big knee left on Jeff. Phantom takes Jeff Jarrett and whoops him into the ropes. Big forearm for the Rock and Roll Phantom. Rock and Roll Phantom, he just took some from Bert Prentice over there. Takes it and stuffs it in that mask of his. Phantom struts around the ring with whatever it is Prentice give him. And a big headbutt on Jeff Jarrett. Two, and the Phantom breaks the hole at about three. Jeff comes out of the corner, runs in, and clobbers the Rock and Roll Phantom. Can't get the big guy out. Another right for Jeff. Comes off the rope. Now's the Phantom, and boy, he goes down. Takes Rock and Roll Phantom, whips him in. Jarrett. Oh, boy, look at him. Jeff Jarrett picks up the big Rock and Roll Phantom. That's not easy to do either. Slams him down hard. Jeff's up on the top rope now. Phantom on his feet. Flying press from Jarrett. He's got him covered. Two. Here comes Bert Prentice, though. Prentice in the ring. Jeff's got him. Clobbers Prentice. Sends Prentice upside down in the corner. Goes up to Rock and Roll Phantom. Slams him into the corner now. That's Jarrett. Runs him to the other side and slams a Phantom. Right from Jeff. Oh, and here comes Mike Samples down the ringside. Holding Jeff. Jarrett gets out of the way. And the Phantom catches Samples. Jeff's got it rolled up. One, two. Oh, he kicks out at two. And here comes Samples and Prentice. And referee calls for the bell. 6 minutes and 30 seconds. Referee Frank Morrell calls for the bell. What's that good time Brian Christopher's got? Jeff, Jarrett, right in the ribs with that good time. Samples and Prentice holding Jeff. Christopher again with the end of that good time. Boy, that's a metal good time he's got in there. What a big electric good time. And here comes the King, Jarrett Lawler. He picks up that good time. Christopher.
Now we know a little more of the history of that guitar.
That's exactly right. Brian Christopher, the film doesn't lie. So Monday night, that's right, you're going to have Lex Luger as your partner. And he is very big and very impressive, and he's got some big old muscles. But Brian, let me tell you one thing. He's not big enough for you to hide around all night long. I'm going to get to you, Brian, and when I do, I'm going to break you open like a hot biscuit, boy. And I can't wait for Monday night.
King, this guy is big.
Yeah, he is big. Lex Luger, I want to ask everybody over here, you all saw Lex Luger come out here, the narcissist, because he's in love with himself. He is big, is he not big? He looks good. I got to admit that. He is.
Wait a minute.
I just want to, I don't want you to get overconfident, because you got to realize that Lex Luger was the world champion in the WCW. And now in the World Wrestling Federation, he is undefeated. He's been hitting guys up there with a forearm and knocks them completely out, Jeff. I mean, they're unconscious. This guy is one of the few guys. You know, a lot of times you go somewhere and people say, well, gosh, you look bigger on TV or something. But he's one of the few guys that he looks bigger in person than he does on television. He's real impressive. I just don't want us to get, I don't want to get overconfident, because I got to admit, we're pretty much outmatched. Don't you think we're outmatched in a match with him? Well, I want to tell you.
You're pretty good as a tag team.
Well, yeah, but Jeff, don't get overconfident.
We were champions last year, and we were ready.
Do you see how big Lex Luger is?
Yeah, he's big.
Do you know how strong he is?
Yeah.
Matter of fact, I tell you what I want to do. If we could, I would like to call Lex Luger out here for just a second. I want to get Lex Luger to come out here. I want to show you something.
If Lex Luger, if you are still here, I'm inviting you. Would you come out here for just 1 minute? There'll be no fighting. No. Look. Come here, Lex.
Yeah, that Brian and Prentice trying to talk him out of it. I heard Brian say, "Don't come, it's a trick."
Lex Luger. Now this side, right here. Come here, Dave. Bring the microphone here, Dave. Come here, Lex. It is no trick. I just want to...
You know, Brian's just a little concerned that things might get a little out of control out here. And now they're out here face to face. We don't have to worry about that, do we?
Not at all.
As a matter of fact, the reason I'm out here is only because these 19-inch TV screens at home, nor these studio monitors, nor nothing can actually do the narcissist Lex Luger justice. You have to actually see me live and in living color to truly appreciate how impressive, how beyond perfection I truly am.
I gotta agree. I'm not gonna disagree with you a bit. Look at this. Wait a minute. Let me see. How tall are you really, Lex? How tall are you?
I'm around 6'5".
Tall enough, yeah. Because I'm 6 foot tall, and I thought that was pretty tall. But you are tall. Yeah. And you say face to face, but I mean I can't really look. I mean if I looked you straight, I'm gonna look at your neck or something there, like. I'm serious. I just want you to one time. I mean, because let's face it, look at this. I'm almost embarrassed to be standing here next to this guy, because look at that impressive physique. That is the most impressive looking physique that I believe I've ever seen in professional wrestling. Look at this, look at the massive chest. Matter of fact, can you do that? Look, I don't want to do it because it's embarrassing, but I mean, look at that. How big do you think those biceps are?
You know, I really don't have any idea. I just everything I have is just phenomenal.
It is phenomenal. Wait a minute.
I don't need a tape measure.
Hang on just a second. Look, I just happen to have a tape measure right here. Do the muscle again. No, it's not a trick. Do the muscle. Do it up. Do it big. Holy mackerel. Wait a minute. That is 21 and a half inches around his bicep. Don't measure mine, please. Can you do like how you guys do with the big chest and everything? Can you do
like a lat spread?
What's it called?
A lat spread.
A lat spread. Lat spread. All right. Make it like you make your chest real big. Yeah. Well, wait a minute. Here. Hang on a second.
Watch out. Wait. Is it up here? Is that only a 60-inch tape?
Yeah.
Let's not go around.
It is 57 inches. 57 inches around his chest. I gotta admit, Jeff, I am so impressed with this man's body. This is truly a perfect body, and you know, there's not a flaw or blemish on it, is it?
No, absolutely immaculate, perfect.
Well, I'm gonna tell you something, Lex. Like I said, I'm almost embarrassed to be standing out here, and I've had a lot of matches down here in Memphis with big guys, big strong guys, and I've been outmatched a lot in the past. And you know, I certainly wouldn't be able to compare physiques or compare strength with you, but in matches in the past that I've had a certain little way of overcoming this whatever you want to call it. I mean, you know, this size and strength advantage. And
I think it's superiority is what you're looking for.
Well, maybe superiority, but like you said, you know, we're maybe just a couple of big fish in a small pond, but we've been around here a long time. And we've been able to last with big guys like yourself coming in here. And wouldn't it be a shame, wouldn't it be horrible if something were to happen to that perfect body, if it were to get a blemish or a flaw on it? Would that not be horrible? Wouldn't it be horrible for something to happen to that body?
I don't think you have to worry about that. The thought, if it even crossed somebody's mind, that would be the last thought that ever crossed their mind.
I believe it. Because that body is so perfect, it would be horrible to have that body scarred or blemished in any way. But Lex, I just want to leave you before we leave. I just want to leave you with a little piece of film clip that I had specially made of some of my past matches to show you how I overcome the size and strength, superiority as you want to call it, of some of my opponents. So Jeff and I are going to go ahead and leave, and you watch this little clip, and you just...
then get their strategy ready.
Yeah, you think about it, okay? And we'll see you Monday night, okay?
Let's look at that video right here, Lex. Oh! The situation is not of your making. Don't mess around with the demolition man. I'm a walking nightmare, and that's another doom. Kill conversation as I walk into the room. I'm a feline whip, I'm a sort of family fan. I'm a walking disaster boy. I'm a walking nightmare, and that's another doom.
Lex, they're gonna try to burn you, Lex. They're gonna try to burn you, Lex. No, that is not gonna be wrestling. Is that what you call wrestling? If the thought even crosses their mind of one blemish, one mark, one scar, one imperfection on what is beyond perfection, it'll be the last thought that ever crossed their mind. They will be dead men. Nobody's burning him. Nobody's burning nobody.
The match is booked for Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum. It's the night of 29 stars. Watch.
A night the stars came out. Monday night.
We've had a group coming to the USWA in recent weeks, which, frankly, a little bit of a surprise. I don't think much of their musical ability, but the matches, you were telling me, they are really looking pretty good in a match you saw just a few days ago.
They're tough and a little cocky, but they are an exciting tag team. They're tough.
Take a look at them. PG-13.
What's up, man? You know what? That Super Bowl, man, 27, bro. Them Dallas Cowboys run all over Buffalo. Wasn't even no competition, bro.
Speaking of competition, you know, since we've been around here, man.
What's up?
You see some competition up there somewhere, man?
There's no cop up there, bro. Hold on.
Is there something under there somewhere?
Bro.
I don't see him. Whoa, behind competition,
man?
Back there?
Ain't nothing back there.
None, man. Where's it at?
What's up? Matter of fact, you know, the USWA ain't got no competition for PG-13, bro. We what's up with 1990, man? Rock and roll is out of shape and out of date. Rapping soul is here to stay, bro. You know, like, you know, tell them what we like, what we are.
We what's going on? We what's happening? Everybody else, the Atari, we the Super Nintendo and the Genesis and all that. We up to date. We happening. We too smooth, man. Too smooth.
Matter of fact, we so smooth. Let them bust on this. Check this out. Jump, 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 jump.
Bring it on, bring it on. Where's the competition? I'm Whoopi D and I'm about to start dissing. The King Jarrett Lawler, what a good place to start. Go watch their gig, ain't nothing but a mark. Yeah, you heard me, now what you gonna do? Not a thing but get Jack, sit down, fool, and Jeff Jarrett. Boy, you think you're so hot. You bleach blonde, so you jump punk to his eye. Now, Jesse Ice, are you ready? It's your time to start rocking the mic and put an end to the rhyme.
Up, up, and away. Here I go, the Mac Daddy, Jason Ice Cold, taking control. I slam you, I'll ram you, I'll show you the deal. Give it up, Danny Davis, cause you're over the hill. Are you an eagle, a nightmare? Who are you, G? How about a straight up honky? Sounds good to me. Richard Lee, to you and your pet poodles. Look at yourself, eating kick-a-poodle. Ha ha, kick-a-poodle. Word up, man.
Reggie B. Fine standing in the ring right now, and you see the name in the lower right part of the screen, and here he is right here. The competition for Mr. Fine is none other than Jeff Jarrett climbs into the ring. He'll be taking off the warm-up jacket, and we will be set to go with USWA Championship Wrestling action. One fall, 15-minute time limit coming up.
Yeah, Reggie B. Fine stepped out of the ring as Jeff stepped in there, and now Reggie's back in, and overhunting all of the fans over there, insulting all of the great wrestlers. Hey, look at Jeff roll him up. May be a quick one, too. Hey, thought Reggie B. Fine was about to go home early. Jeff rolled him up. Oh, look at Reggie.
Yeah, look at Reggie blaming the referee for his problem.
Now he's blaming the fans because he was over chewing them out.
Pay attention to your opponent, Reggie B. Fine. He's been around long enough. He ought to know better than that. But no, I got to blame somebody else. Jeff Jarrett is waiting for it. And here he goes again, talking to the crowd.
Reggie B. Fine into the ring today, telling all the fans, don't call him Candyman anymore.
Step through the rope, get a break out of it, too.
Jeff Jarrett waits. Good arm takedown. Oh, he said he pulled his hair.
He doesn't have any hair.
Boy, Reggie B. Fine, too.
Oh, boy.
Just a good, clean move from Jeff Jarrett.
Yeah, great move by
and
Jeff.
And Reggie B. Fine all of a sudden comes up with some hair that Jeff Jarrett pulled. Good hip toss from Jeff flips him over. Reggie pulls his tights on that one.
Well, he's about to run out of excuses, I think. I don't know how many
quickly
more he can come up with, but pretty soon he's going to have to face the facts that he is facing Jeff Jarrett. And that's his problem. What? Well, was he threatening Jeff?
Yeah, telling Jeff don't pull his tights, don't touch his tights is what he's telling him. Jeff Jarrett tightens up on a headlock on Reggie B. Fine. Takes Fine and good smart move from Reggie B. Gets in the ropes and gets a break out of it.
Time
of
leaving, man.
Oh,
he's threatening to leave now. Hey, I'm gonna leave. He's oh goodness. Reggie B. Fine. What a piece of work, huh?
Yeah. Jeff rolls him back. Oh, reversal in from Reggie B.
Oh.
And Fine with a big elbow takes Jeff Jarrett down.
Well, it was a good move, a good wrestling move by Reggie B. Fine to get his opponent down for at least a moment. He tries it again and it works again.
Yeah, another big elbow from Reggie B. Fine. And Reggie B. Fine with a little strut of his own around there. Takes Jeff Jarrett, whoops him in again. Oh, Jeff goes under this time. He matches him with a flop. He got it. It's on 2-3. Jeff Jarrett gets the win and Reggie B. Fine is defeated. No tights and no hair involved. Jeff Jarrett gets the 1-2-3. Mid-South Coliseum, 7:30 is bell time. 29 stars. Take a look.
The night the stars came out.
The Night Stalker.
Scott Campione. Regina Hale.
Leslie Bellinger. The Master of Terror.
Miss Texas. Danny Davis.
PG-13.
Missouri Tiger Jeff Gaylord.
Dr. Tom Pritchard.
Dutch Mantell.
The Rock and Roll Phantom.
Doug Gilbert.
Hot stuff, Eddie Gilbert.
The Bruise Brothers, Ron and Don Harris. Mike Sample.
The Moondogs and Richard Lee.
The King, Jerry Lawler.
Jeff Jarrett.
Bert Prentice.
Brian Christopher.
And his partner, the narcissist, Lex Luger.
29 stars shine Monday night.
That is the Missouri Tiger. Jeff Gaylord has just climbed into the ring. Bert Prentice is in his corner. His opponent headed this way. There is the King.
So we're about to get this one underway. Jeff Gaylord, with a little pose in there. Missouri Tiger comes in out of St. Louis, Missouri. And the King, Jerry Lawler, wrestles in out of Memphis, Tennessee. Good single bout here today.
What a main event we've got here today. We've got a great crowd on hand here today.
Yeah.
One of the better crowds we have had in a long, long time. Glad to have them and got a great main event here for them today on USWA Championship Wrestling.
Fall 15 minutes in time for this one.
More to the remainder of our TV time here today.
Gaylord backs the King up against the turnbuckle and gives a clean break for a change. One.
Oh, geez.
Bert Prentice wants to tell everybody how great it is to see him here. I have other opinions in that regard.
Yeah.
Please just don't sing. Don't lip sync Garth Brooks song to try to make us believe it's you. How about that, Bert?
Not near Garth Brooks, I guarantee you that.
No, not even. No. 17 leagues apart.
I think Bert Prentice thought Lawler had a hold to him over there. Gaylord grabbed him by his jacket then. Prentice.
Got his stammer.
Oh, yeah, now he goes over.
Look at this. Look at Prentice interfere. He's got, that's Prentice's hand. He's holding Lawler back in the corner.
Hey, come on, Bert, would you? Yeah, now he goes trying to run around the ring after grabbing. Yeah, Lawler's explaining to referee Kevin Sifton. He was pulling my tights there while I was in the corner.
Prentice swears to the referee, I didn't touch him. I did not hold his tights, referee. Yeah, you saw it. Had a camera right on it. You saw exactly what happened. Lawler, what he said he saw Brian Christopher over by the curtain. I see the curtain moving.
Yeah.
Back to action here. Oh, look out. In the ring, it is Brian Christopher.
Whoa! Yeah, but, oh, boy. Well, Christopher kind of stunned and Lawless. Oh, it goes in! He gets out of the way, and Christopher catches Gaylord, and Lawless nails away on Christopher. Look out, King. Gaylord drops down, double right hand.
Prentice is holding the referee over in the corner to keep him out of the action, to try to keep him from separating everything.
Yeah, it comes help, though. Jeff Jarrett comes in. Helps the King out. Well, Prentice has got referee Kevin Christen holding on to Kevin over here. Jeff Jarrett slamming away on Christopher and Gaylord, and boy, they get out of there.
That's what kind of tag team you got as Jeff Jarrett arrives. Brian Christopher, Jeff Gaylord, and Prentice leave. Look out, here comes Lex Luger. Here's Eddie Marlin getting in between them. We better take a break before something gets started here. We'll be back. Well, promotion prevailed there, and nothing got started. Lawler and Jarrett, though, certainly were not backing up one inch from Brian Christopher, Jeff Gaylord, or Lex Luger when he came out here. That match is signed, and it's Brian Christopher admits it's his idea. He's mad at Jeff Jarrett. He saw the opportunity, and he says, hey, Lex, let's get both of them in there at the same time. It should make a great match, though, for you fans. Indeed. Monday night. 29 stars, opening match, the Night Stalker. We'll be going against Scott Campione in the opener. Following that, you got Leslie Bellinger going against Regina Hale. Should be a good one there. Aaron Hatchett will take on one of the Masters of Terror in a single match. Miss Texas will be there. She'll be going against Candy Kane. Then PG-13, as we talked a little bit earlier, that team that turned out to be a little bit surprising. They've got some moves, as Corey pointed out. They got an attitude, though. They'll be going against Danny Davis and his partner Chris Michaels in tag team action. Jeff Gaylord will climb into the ring. The Missouri Tiger, you just saw him against Lawler. By the way, Lawler technically won that match. Yeah. The interference by Christopher, the referee disqualified Gaylord, so Lawler gets the win. But Gaylord will be stepping in against Dr. Tom Pritchard. That should be a great match
to see.
Monday night at the Coliseum during the night of 29 stars. The Rock and Roll Phantom will bring the guitar and Bert Prentice to ringside. The only thing I can hope is that we would be spared with that alleged concert of Bert Prentice and Rock and Roll Phantom, but I doubt it, knowing Prentice. But if you can put up with a concert, get ready because the Dutchman, Dirty Dutch Mantell out of Oil Trough, Texas, will be there, and he will be taking care of business, a guarantee, as he steps in against the Rock and Roll Phantom. Following that, you got the return grudge match. Corey, this one.
Look out for this one.
Yeah, this one is not the same match that we thought it was just a few moments ago. Doug Gilbert came out here with what we felt was a sincere apology to Eddie, and he had promised his mom he would not raise his fist against his brother and all that. Didn't really want this match to occur. And then comes out here and eggs on the Harris brothers and all of that as they jump Eddie Gilbert, and three against one at one point beat him up here in the ring. Eddie will be looking to get even with Doug Gilbert in this return grudge match Monday night at the Coliseum. Richard Lee's hair is going to be on the line. They'll have folks right there at ringside ready to cut the hair if the Moondogs lose it. Ron and Don Harris, the Bruise brothers, the USWA World Tag Team Champions, with Mike Samples in their corner. Richard Lee's hair on the line, but the Harris brothers' titles are also on the line. Then the main event of the night. Get ready for it, fans. You got Jerry Lawler and Jeff Jarrett. Tag team had never backed up from a challenge at all. But on the other side, you got Bert Prentice, you got Brian Christopher, and Christopher has secured as his partner the narcissist, the man that even Jerry Lawler says has an almost perfect physique, Lex Luger. Gee. It should be some kind of night, the night of 29 stars, Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum.
Yeah, we'll be looking for everybody down there at the Coliseum Monday.
All right, Corey, we'll be looking for everybody right here again next week for more USWA action. Until then, for Corey Macklin, I'm Dave Brown. So long, everybody.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of USWA Championship Wrestling.